friends, in this video we'll be seeing about the 7 apps that would help you academically in your med school. Before starting, I would like to tell that these are not the sponsored videos and I'm using this app for a quite long time now, so I just thought to share them with you as these are actually amazing. So to begin with, let's go with the very first app. This is All Medical Mnemonics. In this app, they contain the mnemonics of all the 19 subjects. As you can see, we'll be seeing an example of anatomy. In this, let's see the head and neck mnemonics. As you can see, there's a mnemonic for the symptoms of Bell palsy. That is, the blink reflex is abnormal, earache, lacrimation, loss of taste, sudden onset, and the palsy of the seventh nerve. Another example that you can see is in, supposedly, let's choose the microbiology. And in the bacteriology mnemonics, there's a mnemonic to learn all the capsulated microbes. That is, some nasty killers have some capsule protection. So this mnemonic would help you to learn all the capsulated microbes. The benefit of this app is that it is an offline app, so you can use it anytime and anywhere. Although in my opinion, it's best to make mnemonics of yourself, but in the case that you are having a shortage of time or you ran out of ideas, then this app could be of great help. Okay, so our second app is this MedEasy app. So this is basically an online app and requires subscription, but it has a lot of free content, therefore it's good to use. For example, it provides you daily many MCQs. For example, this: what is the most common genetic cause of congenital heart disease? It's trisomy 21. Okay, so the best thing about this app, which I feel, is that it provides daily clinical cases. For example, this is a clinical case of gastrectomy. This is the presentation of follicular lymphoma, and this is the clinical case of polycystic kidney diseases. Okay, so these cases could be discussed upon by various med students, and you can also learn the various procedures and the comments of the doctor. So the next thing this app provides is the flashcards. For example, this is a flashcard of cardiovascular system, that what can be suspected if the RUP persists without any change of character on holding the breath. Okay, so that the answer of this question would be a pericardial RUP. So these are the various things which this app provides, that is the clinical questions, okay, flashcards, and the various clinical cases. So although this app is not very high yielding, but it could be used just for scrolling purposes. Okay, so the third app we can see here is this AnatLab Histology. This is by far the best histology app I have ever had. This is an offline app and could be used anywhere. It contains the histological section of various tissues. For example, first we'll be seeing the histological section of a salivary gland. Okay, so the best thing about this app is that you can use it per your convenience. Like, you could use it at 50% zoom, 75% zoom, or even at 100% zoom. So at 100% zoom in the salivary gland, you can clearly appreciate that these are the SNR cells and these are the various mucus cells. Okay, in 75% zoom, you could also see that these are the various salivary gland ducts. The best thing about this app is that you can scroll it sideways and even upside down, which gives you an experience much better than viewing just the images of the slides. It gives you an experience like you are using your microscope itself. Okay, so another example we could see is of epithelial tissue. Let's see the cross section of the epithelial skin. Okay, so like this, you can see in 100% zoom, you can clearly appreciate that these are the long columnar cells. Okay, these are the long columnar cells with the nucleus at their base. So like this, this app contains the histological sections of almost all the tissues in your body. So I would recommend that this is definitely a must have app on your phone. Okay, so our next app is this Surgery app. This is an online app, but it's absolutely free to use. This is basically a surgical training simulator in which there are various procedures present for free. For example, we can see in the library the amount of procedures present here. Okay, let us choose the emergency medicine, and this we could learn the chest tube insertion. Okay, so now when we click on this learning procedure, as you can see, the procedure is divided into 59 steps here, as shown here. Okay, then we can proceed. As you can see here, we can swipe to progress. For example, first we learn about the patient positioning, then we can learn about the anatomical marking here, then the point of incision, then we can clean the field, then we could drape the patient, then the injection of the local anesthesia. Okay, as you can see here. Then as we swipe right, they'll also tell how to, which blade to use and how to and where to make the incision. Then you keep using the Kelly's clamp, we could insert the chest tube. Then you can see the approach to the pleural space. Okay, then finally the insertion of the tube. Okay, as you can see here how the tube is inserted. This app provides you each step in great detail. Now you can learn how to suture it, which type of suture. So as you can see, when you are done with the tutorial, this app also allows you to test your learning. For example, as we click on test, okay, here the windows comes which indicates that welcome to the procedure training for the chest tube insertion. So the very first question is, the operation is ready to begin, how could the patient be positioned? As we learned previously, the patient is positioned in the semi-recumbent position. Okay, so we can click this answer and check, okay, and the answer is correct. Okay, so next is what do you do in the next. Okay, I think it was to abduct the ipsilateral arm, and yes, it is correct answer. So by this method you can also test your learning and finally solidify your concepts. So this is a great app for virtually learning your surgical procedures. Okay, so our next app is this AnkiDroid app. This is one of the great app for medical field and was introduced to me by one of my seniors in second year. Okay, so the best part of this app is that it allows you to make your question banks of your own, but you can also get the already made question banks by clicking on here, that is a get shared decks. But the shared decks are made for USMLE patterns, so for Indian purposes it's best to make the questions of your own. Okay, so the principle on which this app works is the spaced repetition. For example, you'll see in short time. So okay, so as I said that you can make your own question banks, I have made this question bank of Robin's histopathology. For example, that is identify the type of inflammation shown here. Okay, so this is granulomatous inflammation. We can see the answer and see that answer is also typed by you, that is the granulomatous inflammation. A section of lymph node shows several granulomas, each made up of each aggregate of epithelioid cells and surrounded by lymphocytes and etc. So what this app does is, if I click this question to be easy, it would be repeated 6.1 months later, whereas if I mark this question good, it would be repeated around 2.8 months later. However, if I mark this question hard, it will be repeated 1 month later. Or if a question is absolutely new to me, I could mark it 10 minutes later. Okay, so this is the basic principle of this app, that is you can repeat a questions multiple number of times till it is cemented in your memory. Okay, so there are various videos on YouTube teaching how to use Anki and how to make your own question bank. So you could go through here and learn how to make your own question banks here, and you should definitely invest your time in this app. Okay, so our sixth app is this anatomy learning app. This is the best app to learn anatomy, and by using this app you can make your own 3D anatomy models. Hard to believe, isn't it? So let's check it out. This is basically an online app, but it's free to use. However, you have to see various sites in order to unlock its content. Okay, so as you can see in the library, there are various pre-made models of bone, muscles, vessels, nervous system, and the various spinalology like respiratory system, digestive system, etc. We'll be seeing the model of the skull bones, and let's see the overview of the facial bones. Okay, so here we can see that there is a model of the facial bones which is already cut in sagittal plane. We can first make it complete. Okay, so when I say that you can make your own models, by that I mean that you can take a bone, have a long press on it, and you can make that bone transparent so that you can see through its structures easily. Okay, you can actually even remove the bone from here and see the internal structures. Another thing this app provides is that you can have a long click, you can slice the entire model in any plane you want. For example, I sliced it from the top so that I can see the base of the skull, and I can even change the plane of the cut section like this. Okay, and back. So this app allows you to be creative and make the models of your choice. Okay, so another thing in which this app could be used is to study the relation among the organs. For example, if we take the structure of the heart, and if we take the model of this. Okay, so this is the model of the heart with its vessels. So suppose if we want to study the relations of this heart with the rib bones or with the lungs, we can do this. For example, here we can choose the bones and cartilage, and from here we can choose, we want to study this relation with the ribs. Okay, so we can choose the ribs here. Although like this, we have to wait for a few seconds in the basic version. So we'll continue with the basic version and we'll add the ribs here. Okay, and if we also want to study its relation with various muscles, arteries, veins, nervous system, we can do this. Okay, or if you, now we'll be choosing lungs. Okay, so we have chosen the lungs and we'll study its relation with the lungs. Okay, so now we don't have to cram all these things from the book, that the relation of the bones and ribs at which aortic arch is present. You can actually see it in your model yourself. Okay, like this, we have removed one entire lung, and we can see the levels of the rib and the aortic arch and the various other relations, like the relation of the azygous vein, etc. Okay, so hence this app provides a lot of information, and this is just a few examples. When you yourself will open this app, you can see that there's a lot of opportunities of making endless number of models of your own and to learn by visualizing them. Okay, so the final app for today is this Clinical Sense app. This is an app which provides you clinical scenarios, and it is an online app, but all its contents are free. So as you can see here, there are various scenarios of surgery, medicine, pediatrics, obs and gyne, psychiatry, etc. So we'll be seeing a case which I have already downloaded, that is of internal medicine, systemic lupus erythematosus. As we start the scenario starts with the very beginning, that is the initial dialogue exchange between the doctor and the patient, and it begins with the history taking and even the physical examination. So the best thing about this app is that during the scenario itself, it asks you questions like, based on the your observations in the history and the physical examination, what is the primary diagnosis that you are thinking of? And that, for example, here it is nephrotic syndrome. Then you could also suspect the underlying cause, like here it is systemic lupus erythematosus. Okay, then the thing about this app is that it provides you side-by-side learning topics. Like, for example, if you have to have an overview of the SLE, you can just click here and a pop-up window will appear describing the SLE. Okay, then moving on, it will ask you about the various diagnosis tests that you would order in order to confirm your diagnosis. Okay, then it will ask you the primary medications that you will prescribe to manage the disease. Okay, then like again, you can see here is a side note for seeing the management of the nephrotic syndrome. Okay, and then there are follow-up questions like about the birth control pills, etc. Then after this, you can have your lab results. You can observe these results and confirm your diagnosis of whether it is SLE or any other diagnosis. Okay, then you can ask the patient for a follow-up examination. Then there you can tell your patient that what is the further procedure in the order to manage the disease. Okay, this completes your scenario. Okay, then you can also view the analysis of your decisions, that whether you took the right decisions or not. So you can analyze your report of diagnosis. Okay, so this ends the scenario. Similarly, there are various scenarios which can be accessed for free in this app, and this can provide you an overall clinical experience. So this was it for the first video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any suggestions, then do comment below, and see you in the next video.